Senator Kennedy, why do you rise?
Would the sponsor provide an explanation, please?
Sponsor provide an explanation?
Absolutely, Senator Kennedy. Thank you very much for the question. We have 11 accredited colleges that have programs for athletic trainers in the state of New York, and many of them are leaving the state because they need to be in a circumstance now with this explosion of athletics in our country. We've seen women's sports in particular grow at a phenomenal rate in the last 25 years through the college ranks, through the high school ranks. And right now, athletic trainers are limited to supplying their services to the colleges and the high schools within the framework of the athletic field. But as everybody knows, in this room, all of us do something else. We are either runners or marathon runners or golfers or tennis players or engage in other adaptive sports. And so this would allow for athletic trainers who must have a master's degree and must have a license to be able to work with those active individuals in adaptive athletics in other settings.
Will the sponsor yield for some questions?
Will the sponsor yield for a question?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
Thank you. Are you familiar with the opposition to this bill from the various organizations that represent physical therapists and nurses and others?
Yes, through you, Mr. President. We've had numerous roundtables on this issue, and we have discussed all the particulars with those who have expressed concerns and really believe that we have had a complete and full airing of their concerns. And we believe that athletic trainers who are licensed, who have master's degrees, or are going to be required to have master's degrees, certainly understand the scope within which they are going to be allowed to conduct the things that they do so well. They must work under the supervision of a physician. And in doing so, we think the safety of the public would be ensured through protection against services from unqualified individuals, because currently right now, athletic trainers are certified. That means, unfortunately, that a lot of people can claim to be athletic trainers who are not and treat people who they should not be treating. So this would allow full licensure and I think allay the fears of many people. But they are going to work under the supervision of a physician. They will not be engaging in things that they should not be engaging in. And certainly that would be part of their curriculum.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Does the sponsor yield?
Yes.
The sponsor yields.
Is the sponsor aware of opposition from the New York State Physical Therapy Association, the Medical Society of New York State, the New York State Nurses Association, and Buffalo Rehab Group?
Yes, we've worked with all of them, I'd just like to point out the Medical Society no longer opposes this legislation, and let me give you an example on the physical therapy side. Let's say you're a marathon runner, and you have you broke a leg. A physical therapist is the person who is going to rehab you and get you back to that point where you can run again. The athletic trainer is the person who is going to take it from that step forward and get you back into marathon capability to be able to run that marathon and get you up to the level that you need to be after that. They in no way are going to be engaging in what the physical therapists do.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Does the sponsor continue to yield?
Yes.
The sponsor yields.
Do you believe that this legislation that's been proposed expands the scope of practice for athletic trainers?
I believe it expands the scope of practice for athletic trainers to extend beyond the athletic field and beyond a high school or a college to be able to help those active individuals in other sports and in other capacities. I'll give you another example of that. Let's take an example of a Cirque du Soleil. Somebody who is engaged in Cirque du Soleil. I think everybody in this room would agree that they are phenomenal athletes in their own right. An athletic trainer would be able to keep them on par, to keep them in top physical condition.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Sponsor continue to yield?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
Are you aware that the New York State Physical Therapy Association, in their memo of opposition, claims that the legislation grants athletic trainers the ability to treat a wide range of conditions that use various clinically appropriate therapeutic modalities and techniques that are currently in place specifically to licensed physical therapists.
Once again, under this bill, through you, Mr. President, once again, under this legislation, the athletic trainers must work under the supervision of a physician. So whatever treatment they are providing will be under the supervision of a physician. Under the bill itself, they are to engage in the prevention, recognition, examination, evaluation, assessment, management, treatment, and rehabilitation of neuromusculoskeletal injuries that occur in active individuals with treatment in accordance with a supervising physician.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Does the sponsor continue to yield?
Yes.
The sponsor yields.
Will the sponsor define an active individual?
Active individuals are anybody who engages in some athletic competition outside the scope of high school or college, outside of the narrow scope that athletic trainers operate under now.
The sponsor continue to yield?
Adaptive athletics.
Does the sponsor continue to yield?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
At any age?
At any age.
At any age.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Can I just point out, Senator, we're not looking to treat geriatric individuals.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Yes, sir.
The sponsor yields.
What about a geriatric individual who's a marathon runner?
Certainly, if they're healthy enough to run a marathon, they might be able to take advantage of the use of an athletic trainer.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Does the sponsor yield for another question?
Let me just point out that if we're talking about somebody who's had a stroke or some other debilitating circumstance, we're not looking to deal with that.
Senator Funke,
this is about adaptive athletics.
You'll yield for another question, sir?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
Thank you. In what types of settings outside of athletic settings are we talking about? Hospital settings, clinical settings, public, private, business, schools? What settings are we talking about?
All of the above.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Does the sponsor yield?
Yes.
The sponsor yields for another question.
Do you believe that this legislation opens the door for the potential for an athletic trainer to take the place of a physical therapist?
No.
Sponsor continue to yield?
Sponsor yield for another question?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
Do you believe that this legislation opens the door for the possibility of an athletic trainer taking the place of a nurse?
No. I do believe, however, that there is always in the medical profession or in treating injuries or when it comes to physical therapists overlapping with doctors or with athletic trainers potentially overlapping with EMS personnel or overlapping with nurses, that there is always going to be some overlap, and that through the proper education, through the proper licensing, that athletic trainers are going to know when it's time to hand it off to someone, somebody else. And I think they're all working together for the same outcome. And I think that in today's world, when it comes to concussion protocols that we're all concerned about on the athletic field, when it comes to those circumstances outside the athletic field in high school or in college, whether you're playing a men's league soccer game, whether you're playing a softball game, I think to err on the side of caution and better care is certainly the way to go. We want people who are athletic trainers to be licensed. We want them to know what they're doing, to take better care of all of us and all of our children.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Senator Funke, you yield for another question?
Yes.
The sponsor yields.
Senator, you mentioned that the legislation put forth will not infringe on physical therapists or nurses. However, the New York State Nurses Association specifically, in their opposition memo, are very concerned that this legislation opens up the possibility for athletic trainers to take the place of the work that school nurses are currently doing. Are you aware of that?
I'm aware of their opposition, but I don't necessarily agree with it because I think they know, and I know, that they work together with athletic trainers now in a high school setting.
Will sponsor continue to yield?
Sponsor yield for another question.
Yeah, and let me just follow up with that, but school nurses do not attend, as a matter of course, athletic contests in high school. Athletic trainers are the ones who are there.
Sponsor yields for another question.
So how they infringe upon that, I don't know. Yes.
Great. First of all, I would disagree with that. If does this bill allow for out-of-state practitioners to practice in New York?
No.
The sponsor continue to yield?
Sponsor yield for an additional question?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
Is the sponsor aware of the New York State Nurses Association opposition memo claiming that this will allow for out-of-state athletic trainers to come to New York with little to no oversight other than what they currently have from another state?
Through you, Mr. President. It's similar to the bill that we passed in this House last week with traveling physicians. If they are traveling with an athletic team, they certainly know their athletes better than anybody else, and they will be able to treat those athletes as they see fit when they are coming from out of state into New York State with an athletic team.
Look, sponsor continue.
I mean, they're not going to give up that right to be an athletic trainer just because they walked into New York State with their own team from Ohio State University or something.
Senator Funke, will you yield for another question?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
If athletic trainers, as outlined in this proposed legislation, if it were to become law, and as the sponsor has already articulated, will be allowed to do their work as defined by this legislation on and off the field, in schools, in clinics, in hospitals, does that not expand the scope of practice well beyond just the neurological issues like concussions on the field, as you have cited?
No.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Senator Funke, do you yield?
Please stand.
Senator Kenny, one moment.
Yes.
The sponsor yields.
What about a broken bone?
What about a broken arm?
A broken bone. A leg, an arm, a foot, hand. Would an athletic trainer under this legislation be allowed?
An athletic trainer would do the initial treatment, certainly, as they would in any athletic contest. They would do the initial treatment, then they would hand off to the physician under which they are being supervised to begin with.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Sponsor yield for another question?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
Under the current proposed legislation, at what point does that treatment end?
After the initial treatment, as soon as there's somebody else on the scene. They can hand off to EMS. They can hand off to a team doctor. They would hand off to a team doctor.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Senator Funke, do you yield?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
Is that outlined in this legislation?
It is not specifically outlined in this legislation. No, it is not. There's no handoff for anybody.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Senator Funke, do you yield?
I just like to follow up. I don't know that there's a handoff in any of these scope of practice circumstances.
Will you yield for an additional question?
Yes.
Senator Kennedy, the sponsor yields.
So, hypothetically, an injury happens at a marathon or on a football field or a hockey rink or a baseball diamond or at Cirque du Soleil, and under the guidelines of this legislation, an athletic trainer is the first on the scene to respond, to do the initial treatment. But it is not outlined in the legislation when that treatment ends. How is that athletic trainer and the profession of licensed athletic trainers in the state of New York supposed to recognize, by virtue of the profession, by virtue of this legislation, that their treatment must end and it has to go to the next level, to a physical therapist, to a nurse for that higher level of treatment?
I understand your point. Through you, Mr. President, the point of the matter is, I'll go back to the beginning, they are always, always operating under the supervision of a physician.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Sponsor yield for a question?
Yes.
The sponsor yields.
Under the supervision of the physician, as outlined in the legislation, is a prescription necessary for that athletic trainer's work?
No. No. But there are written protocols, certainly. I mean, we're talking about individuals who are going to go to school. They're going to be certified as athletic trainers. They're going to get master's degrees. They're going to have to go through a licensing procedure with specific protocols. They're going to have to operate under the supervision of a physician. Yes, are they going to be first on the scene at an athletic contest? If a physician is present, if there's a team doctor on hand, certainly the team doctor is going to be there first. But if there is no team doctor, an athletic trainer is going to get out there and try to do what they can do, what they do best, and be first on that scene, and then certainly be prepared to hand off to the next person. And that could be very well be EMS, could be an ambulance on the scene.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Senator Funke, do you yield?
Yes.
Senator Funke yields.
If we are allowing these out-of-state trainers to come to New York under their guidelines, under their licensure, and they have the same expanded scope of practice, should they be subject to the same requirements that New York State licensed athletic trainers would be under this legislation?
As soon as they come into New York State, they'd be under the same requirements that SED requires of athletic trainers in New York State.
Would the sponsor?
That's state law.
I'm sorry. Would the sponsor repeat that last statement? I'm sorry.
I believe that's state law.
Would the sponsor continue to yield?
Senator yes. Funke, do you yield?
Yes.
Sponsor yields for another question.
Can you describe the modalities that would be allowed to be utilized to treat these injuries by these licensed athletic trainers?
Whatever is within the scope of what they have learned and been able to accomplish. They will do what they can when they can, and then they, again, are under the supervision of a physician, and they would hand off to somebody, if they can't accomplish what they want to accomplish on the scene. I mean, it's like Come on, it's like anything else. You know, you're going to go as far as you can go and you're going to hand it off. But these are qualified individuals. And currently what we have in the state of New York is probably a system where it is so narrow in scope and so limited that fewer students who graduate from the 11 accredited athletic training programs in this state choose to go elsewhere to find work. So it just seems to me that it makes sense to have a better system in place for athletic trainers, given the explosion of sports going on in our state and around this country, so that we understand fully that our kids are protected, that individuals are protected when they go out and engage in athletic endeavors, under the supervision, always, of a physician.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Senator Funke, you yield for another question?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
So this is a B print, and I know that this has been in the works for quite some time by the sponsor. And I know that these various organizations, associations that represent tens of thousands of licensed healthcare practitioners across the state, were at the table negotiating a bill with the athletic trainers that did not expand the scope of practice that infringed upon nursing or physical therapists. Can the sponsor explain what happened to those conversations and why the opposition from the Physical Therapy Association and Nurses Association?
Let me just say this. Athletic trainers right now are one of only two professions that are limited in terms of where they can practice. So if we're talking about expanding scope, we're talking about expanding outside of the athletic field. We very well can be talking about, for example, military personnel now. The federal government has athletic trainers who work with those who go to basic training. When it comes to police and fire, we may be looking at the same circumstances as far as athletic trainers are concerned. We have come together. We have discussed everything at the table. I think it's a matter of people get a little bit antsy when we're talking about scope of practice. It happens in every profession. Everybody is concerned, and they are rightly concerned. But I think that we have addressed every concern that has been brought up by physical therapists, by EMS, by nurses. And I believe that we have something here that makes sense, that protects the public, that protects our young people, and that gives athletic trainers licensing, better preparedness, requires them to go back and get further training after a couple of years to make certain that they are kept up with everything that is brand new in the world of athletics and injuries. And I think that we have addressed all the concerns that all these various groups have had, and I have great respect for physical therapists, great respect for doctors and nurses and everybody. But again, these individuals, licensed athletic trainers, can only operate under the supervision of a doctor. And I think that pretty much says it all.
The sponsor continue to yield.
Senator Funke, do you yield for a question?
Yes.
Sponsor yields.
Can you describe furthermore other treatment modalities that may be used in the extended treatment, since within the guidelines of the legislation there is no end point?
Be according to a written protocol from the physician under whom they are operating and working. I don't want to say operating. They're not going to do operations either.
Will the sponsor continue to yield?
Sponsor yield for another question?
Yes.
Sponsor yields?
So if not, and correct me if I'm wrong, I believe the sponsor said that these athletic trainers would not need a prescription to do the work. That's accurate?
A prescription to do
prescription
work?
Prescription to do their treatment.
No.
To provide the treatment, okay. So under the circumstances that, will the sponsor continue to yield?
Senator Funke, do you yield for another question?
Yes.
Senator Funke yields.
Under the circumstances that an athletic trainer doesn't need the prescription, under what sort of supervisory protocol, supervisory umbrella would the physician provide that oversight?
Through you, Mr. President, again, it's they have standard orders from the physician under whom they are being supervised, and a standard work order for what they're doing, going to do.
On the bill, Mr. President.
Senator Kennedy, on the bill.
Thank you, first and foremost, to the sponsor for indulging me in these questions. I have some very, very strong concerns that, as far as I'm concerned, as it pertains to legislation in this House, are grave concerns to this, as it pertains to this legislation. I believe that the sponsor is very much well-intentioned. I believe that licensure of any health care practitioners, especially in this state, historically and currently, is not only very strong practice, but I think New York State sets a precedent for the rest of the nation to follow. So in licensing, not just certifying athletic trainers, I think generally speaking, that's a good thing. The scope of practice expansion, when we talk about treating an individual on the field, at an athletic event, during an emergency situation, whether it be a concussion or a broken bone or a contusion or an abrasion or any other sort of medical, physical issue that may happen through the course of athletic participation by these active individuals of all ages, it's good to have licensed, supervised athletic trainers. However, when we talk about treatment of those same injuries, and there is no endpoint to the treatment, and it isn't just the immediate emergency intervention during that course of that athletic situation, whatever it may be, we start to get into the abyss of these healthcare practitioners and the scope of practice. And while overlap in communication is good, and the sponsor talked about overlap and these different practices, these different professions overlapping, nursing, physical therapy, occupational therapy, speech therapy, any other sort of healthcare practice, nursing, if I didn't say that already. Overlap in communication is very good, but an overlap, an overextension, and an encroachment on a scope of practice to which both the New York State Physical Therapy Association and the New York State Nurses Association both claim an encroachment on their respective scopes of practice, that's a very bad thing. And New York State, quite frankly, under the guidance of Senator LaValle in the Higher Education Committee and Senator Stavisky in the Higher Education Committee, over decades has refused to allow the scope of practice of any healthcare profession to be violated. And unfortunately, I believe that this legislation does just that. It violates the scope of practice, backed up by the various professions. These healthcare practitioners, you know, we talk about elite athletes. Now, these physical therapists and these nurses, they're elite healthcare practitioners. They go to school for years on end. They go to continuing ed. And again, there are great things in here. Continuing education, that's a wonderful thing. That ensures that, you know, once these athletic trainers are licensed, that they have to continue their education. They have to continue to go back. They cannot be complacent. But if they're continuing to do the work of other professions, it will violate those professions. It'll violate the elite status of those professions, and it will get in the way and set a precedent that I think is very, very bad for healthcare in this state, and very, very bad for the continuing education for, again, specifically amid this legislation as it pertains to physical therapists and nurses, but I believe that there are others. So with that, I would urge my colleagues to vote no on this. I will be voting no on this legislation amid serious concerns of both myself, brought on by the respective professions. Again, I absolutely applaud the sponsor and sponsors, co-sponsors of this bill, for advancing a strong agenda to improve healthcare and those that provide healthcare amid emergency situations on the field. You know, when an individual gets a concussion, you want somebody there that knows what they're doing. When an individual gets hurt in one way or another, you want someone in the healthcare field to know what they're doing to intervene. But it's in the aftermath of that that I think that this legislation goes far, far, too far. And for that, I'll be in the negative, and I would urge my colleagues to do the same. Thank you.